WPW. These patients will have wide complex QRS, so we're talking about that. Wide complex, it'll be greater than three small boxes, greater than 0.12. They'll have a short PR interval, and they'll have a delta wave. Now, wait. I can't remember all that, John. Do you have a mnemonic for how to remember WPW? Yeah, it's WPW. Wide, PR, short, wave. Wide, PR, and wave. That's the EKG criteria for WPW. Wide, complex. PR is short. Delta wave. Wait. If this is a WPW QRS complex, what does a normal QRS complex look like? That's what a normal one looks like. Okay, you got that physiologic Q wave. You don't have that slurring upstroke of the delta wave. Wait, what is WPW? What does this really mean, and how does it affect us clinically? When you look at the conduction pathway where you have the SA node, AV node, and the bundle branches, this line represents WPW. It's an accessory pathway. It's a fast track. Think about it like the Autobahn in Germany where you can drive 140 miles an hour. It's a fast path. If you go down the normal pathway, you'll go with a normal PR interval. If you go down the fast pathway, it'll go hyper fast. Okay? That's why the PR interval is short. The problem is if you put a funnel in right there, if you put a funnel into the AV node, that will increase the electrical resistance in the AV node and push more impulses down the accessory pathway. Funnel is what I call funnel drugs. They're drugs that slow conduction down at the AV node. We'll talk about that more, but I'll tell you that that is your beta blockers, calcium channel blockers, or digoxin. I came on shift the one night, and as soon as I got on, I knew who was on in the emergency room that night because I was doing a hospitalist job. And they said, oh, Doc so-and-so is on, and I knew he wasn't the strongest ER provider. And they said, oh, there's a guy down in the ER who's got a heart rate of 200, young guy. So I'm like, cool, let's go check it out. So I go down there, turned out to be a 30-year-old male whose heart rate was going 180. As soon as I got down there, he went into VTAC, and I shocked him back and came back. So his post-lethal arrhythmia 12-lead showed WPW. But as we backed up a little bit, this ER doc thought it was a new onset of rapid AFib, so gave him cardizem, which is a funnel drug. It didn't work. Gave him some more cardizem. Didn't work. His heart actually went a little faster. So the guy's like, that's weird. Then gave him low pressor, which is a beta blocker, also a funnel drug. Heart rate went a little bit faster. Guy's like, that's peculiar. So he started digloading him, and then the guy went out. What he did was he completely shut off the AV node, sent all these impulses down the fast pathway. What he failed to realize was he actually called the cardiologist. This is what I got. The cardiologist's question was, is it wide complex or not? Because the cardiologist was thinking, hey, this could be WPW, not new onset AFib. The doc just didn't measure it out or didn't read the computer read because it was indeed wide complex.